The idea that we're going to suddenly be shocked one morning because one of these missiles has a nuclear weapon and does something that dramatically changes America, I think is a very dangerous idea, and I find it very difficult to watch the U.S. government be passive.
The congressional study EMP report from 2004 indicated potential casualty rates of 90%.
Civilian National Security Force, the Department of Homeland Security, Canada and Mexico, they were also invited to take part in this simulated EMP attack, no doubt with their own militarized police force. But the drill was truly multinational, as troops from the People's Republic of China were also invited to take part. The Department of Homeland Security evidently forgot to mention this fact in their press release.
With the amount of smartphones and computers and electronics in our car, etc., would be a disastrous event that would cause an enormous amount of damage.
Or what are we working on to prevent it?
Nothing.
This could be one of the most catastrophic events we've ever seen because it could literally paralyze the whole country. It's a scientific fact. Virtually every physicist who's looked at it agrees it is a real danger. And we've learned recently that that danger is compounded because the sun routinely produces waves that, if they hit us at the right time and the right strength, can basically create the equivalent of an electromagnetic pulse attack.
EMP is one of a small number of threats that could hold at risk the continued existence of U.S. civil society.
Just one violent active region on the sun can cause essentially continent-wide, perhaps even planetary scale impacts to our critical infrastructure.
But why don't we do more to protect the systems that we've spent so much time and money developing?
Two possible answers. One is we can't stop them. Or two, we have engaged but have not let them know that. That there are 3,500 companies working in the United States that are front companies for the Chinese Army.
Because they own us. That's the theory. They own us, and there's only so threatening you can be to your landlord or to your bank or to somebody who owns you.
Owning